Good morning, children. Sai Ram. Today we'll do the concluding part of types of sentences in part 3. Children, in the last video we have studied about transformation of sentences, that is affirmative to negative and vice versa. Let's study more about it. Children, when we studied about if not, we have already studied a little about unless, that is subordinate conjunction, which is used for transformation. Let us study something more about this. Unless equivalents are if not, supposing that not, save, except. Let us see with the examples. Unless my father comes, I cannot pay my fees today. So you can, in place of unless, you can write, if my father does not come, I cannot pay my fees today. So what is the technique used? Note that no change is to be made in the main clause beginning with unless. So, unless my father comes, this is the subordinate clause. And what is the main clause? I cannot pay my fees today. So, when you have transformed the sentence and used if in place of unless, you see that the main clause, that is I cannot pay my fees today, remains the same. Only in the place of subordinate conjunction there is a change. So unless my father comes becomes if my father does not come, right? Then remove unless and write if in its place. Not is to go along with the verb. In negative and interrogative sentences, the auxiliary do, does or did should be used. Already you have studied. Thus, the subordinate clause will become if my father does not come, and the sentence will be if my father does not come, I cannot pay my fees today. Let us see the next example. Unless my father permits me, I cannot come. Rewrite as an affirmative sentence without unless. I can come only if my father permits me. So, what is the change? You have seen here, cannot come becomes can come, and in place of unless you write if. So when negative has to be changed to affirmative, both the main clause and the subordinate clauses are changed. Let us see other sentences. Unless I get a taxi, I cannot catch the train. Unless becomes only if, and cannot catch becomes can catch. So, only if I get a taxi, I can catch the train. Unless the rain stops, the match cannot be played. Unless becomes only if, cannot be played becomes can be played. So, how will it change? Only if the rain stops, the match can be played. Let's have some more sentences. Unless there is a medium, sound cannot travel. Unless becomes only if. Cannot travel becomes can travel. So, only if there is a medium, sound can travel. Unless the people cooperate, no great national venture is possible. Unless becomes only if. No great national venture is possible becomes a great national venture is possible. So how will you write? Only if the people cooperate, a great national venture is possible. Next word, prefer. Prefer signifies choice. That means to choose or select before others. Liking, to esteem above another, or esteem, that means to regard or hold in high estimation, that is giving more importance by comparison. Let us see the example and understand. I like Madras, but I like Bangalore better. Now combine using prefer. I prefer Bangalore to Madras. So the above example is compound sentence. Now when you want to make it simple, what can you do? You will write I prefer Bangalore to Madras. So what is the technique used? That is combining the sentences without using prefer. So what have you done? I like Bangalore better than Madras. Now use prefer in the place of two words, like in the place of better and to in the place of than. I prefer Bangalore to Madras. Let us see the next example. The climate of Ooty is good, but the climate of Kodaikanal is better. Use preferable. The same technique is to be followed. The climate of Kodaikanal is better than that of Ooty. The climate of Kodaikanal is preferable to that of Ooty. Next sentence, I would like to have a cup of tea or coffee. I would choose a cup of tea. Combine into a simple sentence using some form of prefer. So the sentence will be, I would like to have a cup of tea or coffee, comma, preferably tea. So I've joined the two sentences by putting a comma and then write preferably T. Let us see the next conjunctions which are used to join two sentences. Though and its equivalents. Though and its equivalents that introduce adverbial clauses of concession or contrast play an important part in analysis, synthesis and transformation. Already we have studied what is analysis, that is breaking up, synthesis, that is combining the sentence, and transformation, that is changing of the sentences. So let's see their usage. Though and although have almost the same meaning, but however, whatever, as, even if, admitting that, still, yet, etc. are used in different constructions and with different shades or degrees of meaning. Though he is old, he still works hard. The same as, although he is old, he still works hard. However well you may deal with him, he will not improve. Same meaning, but see how you can write. Whatever art I might try, he would not care to profit. Young as he is, he supports his parents. He was now very poor. Nonetheless, he was hospitable. This sentence, how you can write? Though he was now very poor, he was still hospitable. Hospitable means, you know, that is, even though he has become very poor now, he is very welcoming and friendly to the guest. He does not know how to behave in company, notwithstanding that he is educated. So this sentence, how can you write? Though he is educated, he does not still know how to behave in company. Let's see the other equivalents of though, despite, in spite of, and notwithstanding. They have the force of concessional prepositions. Despite his age, he was earning his living. Or in spite of his age, he was earning his living. Or notwithstanding his age, he was earning his living. It can be written as, though he was old, he was earning his living. So it means the same. Let's have the next conjunction, lest, meaning so that not, or fear that. Take an umbrella, lest you should be caught in the rains. Remove lest or rewrite as a negative sentence. So what can you do? Take an umbrella so that you may not be caught in the rains. So you have made it negative. What is the technique use? Note that there is no change in the main clause. Take an umbrella. The changes to be made are in the subordinate clause. Lest you should be caught in the rains. So what you have to do? Remove lest and write so that in its place. Remove should and use may not in its place. So positive will be negative. Let's see the second example. You can use a second meaning for fear that. He makes haste lest he should be late. Remove lest or rewrite as a negative sentence. He makes haste for fear that he may be late. So what is the technique used? Remove lest and write for fear that in its place. That is in the main clause. And remove should and use may in its place, which is in the subordinate clause. In the examples first and second, the original and the transformed sentences are all complex. You may sometimes be asked to rewrite a given sentence as a simple one. He makes haste lest he should be late. So remove lest or rewrite as a simple sentence. He makes haste for fear of being late. So what is the technique use? Remove lest and write for fear of in its place. Remove the predicate should be. Use the present participle being. As the predicate is removed, the subject he also is removed. So what do we find? What is a simple sentence now? He makes haste for fear of being late. Children, I hope you have understood whatever has been taught today. After the end of this video, there will be a link you have to click on the link and submit your answers. Thank you.